Myanmar has installed Htin Kyaw as the country's ninth president. The first truly citizen president in over 50 years, President Htin Kyaw and his 18-member cabinet officially takes the helm 2 days after the historic inauguration held in Naypyidaw. In his two-minute inauguration speech, the new president pledged to work towards national reconciliation, strive for peace with ethnic rebels, and improve the lives of the country's 54 million people. The ceremonial transfer of power at the presidential palace was also brief and lasted for 5 minutes. Diplomats who attended the ceremony warmly welcomed the new president.
And the new president and his cabinet and the parliament can count on the support of the European Union to accompany them in this transition, which might be challenging sometimes because, and this is normal, it happens in all countries in the world, so difficulties are not abnormal, but I'm sure they will be overcome, and again the EU will be there to accompany this country on this journey that we very much welcome.
Htin Kyaw, a longtime confidant of Aung San Suu Kyi, was chosen as her proxy because the constitution bars her from becoming the president. However, she has vowed to be above the president and the recent move by the ruling party to propose a draft creating a new post of state councillor for her comes as no surprise. But analysts were cautious about this move.
What she's doing is creating alternative ways to be able to effectively govern the country, even if she can't officially govern the country. And in many ways, that's probably in line with what ordinary Burmese citizens want. On the other hand, she's been fighting for democracy, and one could argue that using these kinds of means to go around the official system and putting in a proxy president isn't really a democratic process.
It seems to me that this may only antagonize the military. Right now, it's important that both sides, the military and Aung San Suu Kyi and the NLD, build up levels of trust that are lacking so far. This is very important for the future. It seems to me Aung San Suu Kyi may be testing the limits of how far she can go in this new role that she's going to play.
Aung San Suu Kyi's choice of 69-year-old Htin Kyaw, an economist and the son of a renowned scholar, Min Thu Won, was welcomed by most people in Myanmar.
He's a man of integrity and he's a very nice, you might say, a real gentleman, you know, very sincere and honest and likable, you know, friendly. He has worked with Dosu for a long time, for I think over 20 years, and they know each other very well. Well, we all went to the same school, the missionary school, and I think he and Dosu are only about 1 year, he's 1 year younger, I think, and they can work together, I'm sure. And his wife also is very, very capable person. And she's a member of parliament. And she used to work for UNICEF. And she's an expert on education.
Htin Kyaw was also active in charity work for Dok Kin Chi Foundation, established by Aung San Suu Kyi in memory of her late mother. President Htin Kyaw takes over a country which has been under Western sanctions and also rated as one of the least developed countries in the world. Analysts say his government will definitely face challenges.
The military still holds significant political power. So the military has 3 key ministerial positions, including the Minister of Home Affairs, the Minister of Defense, and the Minister of Border Affairs. The military also has 6 out of 11 representatives on the National Defense and Security Council. And the military also holds power in the parliament because 25% of the seats in the parliament are reserved for the military. Another challenge is the peace process. So there are a number of groups who have already made a ceasefire agreement. They signed the nationwide ceasefire accord with the outgoing government, but it's not clear whether that accord will continue to be recognized by the incoming government. And then the third challenge is how to effectively administer the country and really bring about an improvement in the standard of living for the people in the country.
The people of Myanmar who voted for change have high expectations from the government led by party leader Aung San Suu Kyi and the new president. But for the coming weeks, they will be busy preparing to celebrate the traditional New Year and also to usher a new dawn of democracy in Myanmar. Doris Dunn, Burmese Service, Voice of America.